Hi guys, it's Megan from Megabox Savings. I am going to share with you guys what I'm doing for lunch and supper today. And so what I'm doing right now is I am making my Italian pull apart pepperoni bread. And what I did here was I cut slices this way, about 2 to 3 inches apart. And then I did it the other way. And so here it's just nicely sliced up. And what I did was melted butter and put just some garlic powder and some Italian seasoning inside the butter and stirred it up. And I made a little bit more, made about a cup of butter, melted butter with the seasoning because I added butter inside the cracks here, and then I will add it on top as well when I'm done. So what I did was I cut up some pepperoni, and I actually cut up some salami as well. I just had the actual big slices from the deli. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the pepperoni inside the cracks. So, let's see here, what would be the best way to do this? So, sorry for all the mess, but so here I'm just gonna show you guys, all you have to do is basically pull apart the bread and add it inside of the bread. And that's all you do inside of there. And then at the end, I'm just going to sprinkle some cheese, Italian cheese, and then I'm going to actually put some Parmesan cheese and just sprinkle it all over inside and on top. And actually I thought about cutting up some provolone cheese. I got some provolone cheese from the deli as well, and thought about cutting that in slices and putting that inside the bread as well. That would be really cheesy and gooey and really yummy. So hold on a second while I wash my hands because I touched my phone. I actually made my own marinara sauce for dipping when it's all done. And all I did was use what was on stock, because I actually have, I didn't have any marinara sauce, surprisingly. I usually have that on backup from couponing. I can usually get it for 49 cents, 50 cents a can. What I'm doing right now is putting all the pepperoni and salami inside the bread and just pulling apart each section. I'm going to add the cheese and put it in the oven at 350 for 10 to 15 minutes. Then it will be done. And I'm really excited because this is super easy for the kids. And then I will probably just cut up some apples or make a smoothie. That way they get their fruit intake as well. I actually got the Italian bread for 49 cents at Walmart because, you know, if they make too much and it's gonna expire, they have to mark it down. And so that is how I get super inexpensive meals, is to kind of do that. And actually I got my pepperoni, provolone, and salami all for like $6 because I had a $3 or $4 off of $10 Baker's special customer or best customer coupon. And so it was off of any bakery or deli item. So that was really good to use for my meats and cheese. And then now I'm going to add on, I actually thought about putting marinara sauce kind of inside the cracks. I might do that. Because just a little bit, you know. I'm gonna try it on half of it. the cracks and make it kind of pizza-y. And then just do it on one half and then the other half leave it regular. Kind of try that. I look up the recipes, but I don't follow the recipes because I like to add in my own flavor. Measuring my, I don't know what I'm talking about. I use my own measuring device, I guess. So when you're making this bread, it kind of starts falling apart, and I wish I could show you at the same time I'm doing this, but it's just not easy doing this with a phone. All I'm doing is just stuffing this with cheese in the cracks of the cut, the slices. And I'm actually adding quite a bit because I would like to have the bread. The bread's falling apart on the sides because there's just some pieces that are going to fall apart on the ends. The way it's cut in slices, it's kind of hard to explain. But if you do this recipe, you'll kind of know what I'm talking about. And then I'm going to sprinkle some of the Parmesan on top. I don't buy the pre-made Parmesan that you can buy because I like the more of the fresh instead. And so all I'm doing now is just taking the rest of my butter mixture right here with the garlic and the Italian seasoning and just kind of throwing it on top. That way the bread's nice and glazed, per se. Kind of on the sides, on the outside of the sides and stuff. So I'm gonna put this in. It's going to go in the oven for 350 for 10 to 15 minutes. Here is the final product. So you can see how this is falling apart. So you just kind of have to tuck those sides in if you can. Otherwise, just leave it because it'll just be a cheesy bread. For 10 minutes because it just cooks a little bit faster in my oven. So now I'm going to make dinner. I actually have a pork tenderloin in the crock pot. I haven't started it yet, but I actually put that in the crock pot, and then next to the pork in the crock pot, I'm going to add potatoes. And all I did was pre-cut some foil, and I'm going to wrap the potatoes in the foil. And I'm actually going to use, sorry, you guys are in my cupboard right now, so I'm actually looking for some salt. Preferably, you want to use like a sea salt. Or no salt, you could just add nothing to it. Just want to poke your holes in your potatoes. I usually do on both sides. Usually like 5 to 10, depending on how big your potatoes are. And then all you have to do is take the salt and put it inside your foil like so. And then I washed my potatoes so the salt will stick to that. And then just wrap it up. And then wrap all of those up. And put it right next to the pork inside your crock pot. And I'll show you here when I'm done wrapping these. And that way the crock pot does all the work for you for dinner. I'm actually going to do some crafts today, so that's why I kind of wanted to have everything made for dinner tonight. I wouldn't have to do so much prepping. So you're gonna come with me. Sorry if it gets a little jiggly. I'm gonna take my potatoes and throw them in my crock pot, just right next to the pork. And it doesn't matter if it's touching the pork because the pork will cook. And if you get a little bit of gooiness on the outside, it's gonna be okay. So there I have that. And I'm going to put it on high for 4 hours. And I actually will show you the pork that I got for $3.51. And here is that. So I got that at Baker's. Wash my, throw that out and wash my hands. And in a matter of 15 minutes, I have lunch all ready and dinner. And all I have to do at the end of the day when dinner is ready is take my pork out of the crock pot and boil the potatoes and serve dinner. And I'll probably make kind of green bean casserole. That kind of sounds yummy. And make some of my own green bean topping, the French onion topping or whatever that stuff's called. And all I do is I cut up onions and I take the onions, my own onions, and I flavor them with actually like a gluten-free flour, all-purpose flour. And all I do is I take the, and I know cream of chicken isn't gluten-free, but I try to eliminate as much gluten in our, at least my diet. The kids don't have to, but I do limit my gluten intake. So the pizza, I actually won't eat the pizza pull apart stuff, but that'll be for the kids for lunch, and then they can snack on that stuff too, and I can always warm it up later and it'll be really good. So all I do is cut up the onions, and then I throw them in some milk and kind of soak them for a little bit, and then I take those onions out and then I toss them in the gluten-free all-purpose flour, and I fry it up in a frying pan with some oil, and then throw it on top of the green bean casserole, and I just cook it just like normal, and it is delicious. So I actually prefer the regular onions, the actual fresh onions fried up versus the canned. So I just think it's delicious that way, and I've made it like that for years. So that is for dinner tonight, and that'll actually be really easy because all I have to do is throw in all the cans and stuff, mix it all together, and then just fry up some onions, which takes literally no time at all. And that'll be our dinner for tonight. So it'll be super easy. Like I said, I'm going to do crafts today, so I wanted to make dinner as light and easy as possible. So all I have to do is put it on the plate, basically, and dinner's done. So thank you guys for watching my video. Hope you guys liked today's video and just like to other kind of ways I buy my food for my family and how I put stuff together at little to no cost. And everything that I have today cost me under $5, if not under $6. Then my dinner is going to be probably under $7. So thanks for watching. Hope you guys like my videos. Dinner was done in 15 minutes. Lunch was done in less than 15 minutes. Everything was done. Lunch and dinner combined, 15 minutes. I can't complain about that. So thanks for watching. If you guys like my videos, please follow me on YouTube and like my page, and comment below if you have any questions or would like to see any other savings or recipes.